Arktur, future submarine concept, with Surrogate-V, huge unmanned underwater vehicle, Russia unveiled in Arms Expo 2022. A model of what has all the earmarks of being another smooth-looking submarine idea has showed up in plain view as a component of the Army 2022 exhibition in Russia. The design, known as Arktur, is seen matched with a huge unmanned underwater vehicle called Surrogate-V in pictures from the Trade Expo floor. The Arktur and Surrogate-V models, among others, the eighth emphasis of this yearly occasion, opened today at the Patriot Park in Kubinka just outside Moscow. The name Arktur seems to convert into English as Arcturus, which is the most brilliant star in the Boötes Constellation, while Surrogate-V is essentially Surrogate-V. Insights regarding Arktur are very restricted, yet a bulletin before the model seems to show that it is planned fundamentally to be a ballistic missile submarine, or SSBN, improved for activity in the Arctic region. The model plainly shows a smoothed-out hull form, with a position of safety sail. On the off chance that the model is of a similar scale as the one of a Project 955A Boré-A ballistic missile submarine close to it, it's conceivable that the two could have a for the most part comparable generally size. The Boré-A plan is just shy of 558 feet in length, is around 44 feet across at its largest, and uproots around 24,000 tons while lowered, as per openly accessible information. The Arktur seems to have a full covered propulsor plan or the like, that looks intended for water to come in through four separate pipes on one or the other side of the harsh on top and base and afterward get pushed out through spout segments at the back. The siphon jets are more productive in certain occurrences than run-of-the-mill propellers and can decrease a submarine's acoustic mark remaining however quiet, as conceivable seems to be vital to any submarine's endurance. There's no sign without a doubt that it has a more original drive framework, similar to an all-electric design of some sort. It inspires contemplations of the fictitious magneto-hydrodynamic caterpillar drive from the renowned Tom Clancy novel The Hunt for Red October and the film of a similar name. Rather than a more customary cross or X-molded rudder and tail blade plan, Arktur has two arrangements of internal inclined vertical tail fins above and beneath one or the other side of the tail segment, as well. Concerning Arktur's evident capacities, however portrayed as a SSBN idea, the most quickly outwardly getting components are the two huge side-opening payload straits towards the harsh, one of which is portrayed on the model as containing a Surrogate-V. The UUV has an extremely low profile plan, too, with what seems to be a solitary siphon fly propulsor at the back. It likewise has a what might be a cover plan of sorts, comprised of decorating blue triangles, on top of its frame. The example could make it more challenging to outwardly detect the robot submarine while it running at or near the surface, particularly in littoral regions. The UUV could have to work close to the surface. The Arktur model shows that the plan has somewhere around 12 enormous payload tubes along its back body. Two are portrayed as open, one with a level top cover that could mirror an in an upward direction send-off missile of some kind stacked inside, and one more with a lengthy arm holding what seems to be a little torpedo-like, UUV. Arktur hopes to have four torpedo tubes, two each on one or the other side of its bow. There gives off an impression of being the blueprint of an enormous stretched hatch in the middle top piece of the bow that is normally seen as on Russian submarines, and is ordinarily connected with the stacking of torpedoes and other torpedo tube sent-off payloads. The layouts of a variety of little incubates on top of the sail look probably going to be related with full retractable periscopes and other sensor poles. Based on what is noticeable on the model and what have via the authority portrayal, Arktur is an exceptionally fascinating idea for a future SSBN, particularly its possible capacity to convey up to two Surrogate-V UUVs. While it's not completely clear what the planned capacities of those unmanned submarines may be. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.